Hey friends, welcome to today's video. Today we're talking all about eye makeup tips and tricks. So by the end of this video, you guys will have pretty much all my tips and tricks on how to enhance the eye, how to alter the eye, how to understand light and dark, matte and shimmer, and how that all plays into creating the perfect eye makeup look. So we're creating this look today. You certainly can take the tips and tricks that I'm sharing to create any type of eye makeup look, whether it's a smoky eye, whether it's a one shade all over. I'm really trying to make these videos less product specific, product or shade specific, and more the basics and fundamentals of makeup application so that you can take what you learn from today and apply it to other makeup techniques and eye makeup. So I hope you guys enjoy this series. This is the second video of this series. The first video was all about complexion, bronzer, blush, how to achieve a natural but well-covered, flawless complexion that stays on the skin and is long-wearing. So I kind of tell you how I like to mix certain primers with foundations, cream versus powder. That video will be listed in the description box below. The next video will be all about lips, which is why I don't have any lips on because I'm about to film that video next. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and get started. So my first tip when it comes to eye makeup is to always use an eye primer. Even if you don't have an oily skin, our lids can get more oily because there's a fold there. And especially in the summertime when it's hot, our skin warms up. So if you have dry skin, you'll find that your lids typically will still crease or produce some level of oil. So I always like to use an eye primer before I do my eye makeup. I am using the Urban Decay, I think it's called the Shadow Insurance. What is it called? Primer Potion is what it is. I'm gonna put a little bit of this. Now, when you're picking a primer, I like to use a primer that is pretty translucent. You can see this is not colored. There's a slight tint. All that really does is help brighten up the lid. So if you have a darker lid, like a lot of us do, or you have veins on the lid or anything like that, it'll kind of help even things out. But the reason I like a translucent one, I like it for a few reasons. First, it's lighter weight. And I say this all the time, but the name of the game, you guys, is light little bitty layers of makeup. You can use a ton of products, but the name of the game, I keep saying that today, the name of the game. The goal is to use little layers of it so that you don't have a heavy built up, heavy looking makeup. So it's a lighter consistency. It's not as thick as like a cream shadow. I also like that because it's not going to alter the color of the shadow. So when you put the eyeshadow on, it's not going to tweak it. All it's really going to do is intensify it. That's another great reason to use a primer. Even if you're not using it for the wearability benefits, it will magnify and increase the color of the eyeshadow. And let me actually show you guys what I mean. So if I take a primer and I put it on my hand, okay, I'm gonna just kind of rub that in. Now I'm gonna show you what shadow looks like applied with a primer versus just on dry skin. Okay, so we're gonna take this shade right here. So the palette that I'm using is one of the Sephora I Love palettes. I'll have it linked down below. Now I'm taking shadow and I'm gonna put it on a dry part of the skin, okay? And this is the back of my hand, so my hand is really dry. But this is what that payoff looks like. Pretty sheer, right? I mean, obviously I can build it if I want, but I just wanna show you guys, look what it looks like on top of a primer. Do you see the difference? This is dry and then that's primer. It grabs it. It acts like glue. It gives the shadow something to adhere to. So that's another reason why primers are so important. I mean, that says it all right there, you guys. So now that I have the primer on, I like to start with my brow highlight. And I like to use a shadow that is definitely brighter. It's the brightest shadow that I'll use on the whole eye makeup. And I like to use either a matte or a satin eyeshadow. I don't like to use anything really frosty. I personally just don't like that look. I feel like it's a little dated and it's not natural. I like to just kind of highlight right under the brow. I'm using this shade right here in the palette. It's just the matte, lightest bone color shade. And I like to use a more dense brush. So when it comes to eye makeup brushes, these are the makeup brushes that I'm gonna be using so you guys can see the shape of the heads. These are all BK Beauty, of course, but you guys, surely, you know, everything you, any brand you have will work, but I just wanna give you an idea of the shapes of the brushes. So these two are the more dense brushes. You can see that the fibers are shorter, they're more dense. These are the blending brushes because they're longer and fluffier. So these are gonna be my like workhorses. These are the guys that are gonna just pack on a lot of product. And these are gonna be my blending buddies. These are the ones that are gonna help blend it out, make everything look airbrushed and seamless. And this is what I'm gonna be using for eyeliner. So to apply the brow highlight, I like to use something more dense. So I'm using the 203 by BK Beauty, any basic flat eyeshadow brush will work. And I'm really gonna load it up. I want that to be bright. The reason that we are brightening there is because we are kind of lifting the brow. Now my brows need to be tweezed, but we are in quarantine and I haven't had a brow appointment in like 3 months. So what that lightness does is it catches the eye and highlights that brow bone. So it gives the illusion of a lifted eye, a lifted brow bone. So that's why we do a lighter shade there. A little bit of a sheen is fine, but again, I don't like it to be really frosty. You want it to be subtle. You don't want it to be really what your eye is drawn to. Then next, I like to go and create shape in the crease. Now, when you're creating shape in the crease, there's a couple things that you're looking for. You are looking for a shadow that is a few shades darker than your natural skin tone. That's the first and most important, is it needs to be a few shades darker than your skin. I always recommend a matte shade here because matte creates more definition than shimmer does. Shimmer reflects light, so it gives the illusion that something is protruding, that something is coming out a little bit. Matte recedes light, so it gives more of the illusion of more depth, more definition. So I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna use this shade right here in the palette. Which one? This one right here. No, yeah, this one right here. It is a mid-tone taupey matte brown. It is pretty much the ideal transition shade for anyone that is light to medium skin tone. Obviously, the darker you are, the darker your transition shade is. The lighter you are, the lighter your transition shade is. Now, I like to use a fluffy brush. So I like to use something that's rounded, something that's just really gonna give a nice wash of color. If I were using a darker crease color, I would use something a little bit more tapered so I had more control over where that eyeshadow was applied. I want it to be a nice sheer wash because I am gonna go in with a darker shade to create more definition and I'm gonna save this guy for that. But to start to build the transition shade, I'm using a round, fluffy brush and I'm just gonna get on the tip. Now, I always start in the outer corner of the eye. If you watched my video on complexion products, you heard me say that the first place you put your brush is where the most product is going to come off. I want this outer corner to be darker than here. I don't want a lot of heavy darkness built up here. So I'm starting in the outer corner. I'm going back and forth, and then I'm kind of just buffing in little circles. Sorry, my watch is just like buzzing off. So I'm just gonna kind of work in little circles and then go back and forth in like a windshield wiper mode. So I kind of like to build it to about that level. You can always come back and add more if you want it to be a little darker, but I'm really just trying to create definition here. That's how I like to approach the makeup look. I like to kind of start in little layers, evaluate, and then add more if I need to, rather than go in with a lot all at once and then have a hard time blending it out or making it look more natural. So I like to just go back and forth. When I used to do wedding makeup, you know, it's interesting, people's interpretation of natural or smoky or dramatic is also different, right? What I consider natural, someone else might consider like way too much makeup. So I would always be very conservative in my application. And I would tell people, I'm like, if you look in the mirror and you're like, this is just not enough makeup, tell me. I want the feedback. It's all about creating a look that makes them feel beautiful, not about what I think is beautiful. Okay, so back and forth, back and forth. Now, at this point, I'm just gonna kind of evaluate both sides. I feel like this side is a little bit deeper, so we're gonna go and add more on the outer corner here. Okay, so now what you have is you have some more definition. You've created that lightness to help lift, and you created that deeper shade to create more of a crease, give the illusion of a more, you know, defined crease. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add even a little bit more in the outer corner. One, because I want a little more definition there, but I also want the makeup to look a little bit more glamorous, a little more dramatic. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this brush. This is a pencil brush. So it's very dense and it's very small. So the great thing about this brush is that it does a great job of really, really concentrating color in a perfect tiny little area. If you have very small hooded eyes, this would actually be great for your lid brush. It doesn't have to be just used on the outer corner. Use it for the best way of your eye shape. Now I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna grab this darker shade right here, this medium shade, and we're gonna load the brush up and we're going to start in the outer corner and then I'm gonna kind of blend it into the crease a little bit. So we're gonna start right there, press, just kind of pressing, then I'm gonna go and kind of blend it. Now this pencil brush is a little more round. Some other pencil brushes are more pointy. I will actually show you. I think I have one to show, just one sec. Okay, so I have three brushes. I have the BK Beauty. You can see it's really rounded. And then I have a MAC pencil brush. No, I'm sorry, this is a Sigma pencil brush. And this is also Sigma. I thought one was MAC, one was Sigma. But you can see how pointy the Sigmas are. These are really great for concentrating shadow like on the lower liner or creating a really cut crease. Because this one is more rounded, it's actually gonna do a little bit of the blending work for you. So I'm going to kind of run it in. Because this shade isn't too dark, I can do that. I'm gonna just kind of blend it that way. I'm gonna go ahead and lay the other side down, and then I'm gonna blend it out a little bit more. So I'm just gonna press, and then kind of softly create that crease by pulling it in. You can also pull it a little higher if you want to create more of a rounded eye. This is the best time to do that. Take a brush like this and round out that crease. If you want to create an almond eye, you can use this brush to really kind of pull out and elongate the eye. Okay, we're about there. I'm going to go ahead and take the crease brush. I didn't add any product to it. I'm just going over it to soften everything out. Now, don't worry about things looking perfect because we are still building here. This is just kind of building the foundation to the eye shape. Okay, you don't need to worry about it being perfect. You just want to kind of get the bones there. All right. Okay, and last, what I'm going to do just to kick it up and make it even a little more glamorous, I'm going to take the darkest shade, which is here. So when you're creating an eye with multiple shades like this, you always want to start lightest to darkest in the crease. Okay, so that's what we did. We started with the lightest. We worked our way to this one just now, and now we're going to work our way out here. And this particular one, I'm not going to take it into the crease. I'm just going to keep it really focused right here. I'm just pressing, okay? I'm not even gonna blend it out. I'm just pressing, and then I'm gonna go to the other side and press. What I'm doing here is saying, okay, I want this to stay right here. I don't wanna pull it in. I just want it to stay right here. Now it looks crazy, it doesn't look blended. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take my 202 brush. It's more of a tapered brush. I'm gonna start with that tip right there in the outer corner, and I'm just kind of working in little circles and blending it, softening the edges, making it look more airbrushed, you know, not just kind of like a blob of color. Now, I didn't add any product to this brush. Again, this was a clean brush, and I'm just gonna kind of go back and forth, little circles. All right, now my particular eyes, you probably have noticed this, but my eyes are very different shaped. This one is more open, is that right? This one is a more open one, and this one tends to fold down a little bit. That's always kind of working against me, so I do the best that I can to kind of balance that out with shadow, but you know, it's just my face. Then what you can do if you really wanna like blow out that crease, make it real diffused, take the tip and hold it upside down, position it like this. The bristles are tapered, so they're longest at the tip, and then they get shorter and shorter and shorter. So when you stick it in the corner and do that, you have all of those bristles just working for you, those fibers, and they're just kind of smoking it up, giving it a very smoky, airbrushed finish. So I'm gonna do that until I get to a point where I'm like, yeah, that looks good. So now that we've created definition in the eye using dark matte shades that we've gradually built, now we're gonna create a highlight on the lid, which is gonna give even more definition to the eye, because again, a highlight and a shimmer reflect light. So it's gonna make that lid look like it's coming out more, and which is also going to make that crease look like it's defined more. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into the palette, and there's three great shades for me to choose from. I'm only gonna use one. I don't really need to mix too many of these shimmer shades. What I find with shimmer shades that are really close in tone like this, when you build different shades next to each other, they all kind of look like one anyway. So I'm actually going to go with the middle shade right here. It's a really pretty shimmery champagne shade. And it's light enough to where it's going to make that lid pop. These are also built with lightest, medium, and darkest, but because they're also shimmery, even the darkest one is still going to reflect light. So I'm going to grab the 203 brush, and I'm going to load up the side of the brush. I'm going to really load up the side. I'm not using the tip. I'm using the side because I'm going to pack it on the lid. So I'm going to tap the brush. I like to tap it on my finger. If you tap it onto a plastic or hard product, you risk damaging the ferrule or the handle. So just tap it off on your finger And I'm gonna go in and I'm just gonna press that onto the lid, you guys. You don't wanna blend it out too much. You don't wanna move your brush around too much because it'll shear it out. I want this to be packed on that lid. Now I'm concentrating in the inner corner and then bringing it to meet that shadow. I don't wanna go over that shadow. I wanna keep that dark matte shade clean on the outer corner, because if you take a shimmer and go over it, it just kind of muddies it. Now you don't have to use shimmer. If you have really textured eyelids and you feel like shimmer makes it more apparent, which it will, well, you have options actually. You can use a sheen shadow, which is really nice and looks great on more textured eyelids without magnifying texture. You can use cream shadows. Cream shadows are so beautiful if you like a little bit of shimmer on the eye. They definitely look more natural and lay on the skin in a softer way. But you can also use matte. You can still use matte and get definition. You just want to use a lighter color. So you want to make sure that there is a good, you know, difference in color range from the lid to the crease. Now this, again, you guys, is just one eye makeup look to create definition. You don't have to do your eyeshadow this way. You can certainly do a look where it's all dark all over the lid if you like something smoky. This is just a way to create more definition in your eye if you have more of a hooded eye, or you just want to create more definition. This is how I like to do my makeup. I feel like this is the most flattering on my eye shape, but it's not the only way to do makeup. So now what I'm doing is I'm taking that crease brush. I didn't add anything on it. I'm just running it over. You'll find me do this a lot. This just like really perfects that blending. Okay, so for my liner, I like to use a chocolate brown and I like to have a little bit of shimmer to it. It's just my personal thing. Black is fine, dark matte brown is fine, purple is fine, any liner of your choice is fine. I'm gonna show you guys my favorite trick to create an elongated winged liner. I've shared this a lot. If you're not new to my channel, you already know what I'm gonna do, but I'm gonna share it anyway. So I'm taking a Kohl pencil, a pencil that is soft and waxy, but once it sets and dries, it stays in place. It's not gonna move around or smudge. And I'm going to line the eye. Now I'm not too concerned with getting it perfect, you guys. It's gonna look a little messy. You're probably gonna think, what is she doing? She has no idea what she's doing. What I'm doing here now is I'm making it a little thicker in the outer corner, okay? I want it to be thicker in the outer corner. I don't want it to be too thick in the inner corner, because when I close my eyes or when I open my eyes and look directly at you, if it's too thick, all you're gonna see is that liner. You're not gonna see that lightness. So keep it thin, thicker on the outer corner. Then I'm gonna take a tiny little angled brush. This is the BK Beauty 208 brush. This brush is so cool. I love this brush. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just go over that liner. I don't have any eyeshadow on here. You could if you wanted to deepen it or set it, but I don't have any shadow. And I'm just gonna run it over that liner, and then I'm gonna use it to pull that liner out a little bit to elongate it. This is going to give it a slight wing. I think I need a little more, actually. I let it dry too quickly. Okay. So you wanna work with it while it's still creamy. If it dries, then you're gonna have a hard time doing this trick, but I'm gonna just pull it out to elongate it a little bit and lift the eye up. I'm gonna take a little bit of shadow just to intensify that a little. There we go, perfect. Now I pulled it out a bit because I am gonna put false lashes on, so anytime you put false lashes, it's gonna kinda tone down any liner or shadow that you did, because the focus will be on the lashes. I'm gonna go and do the other side and I'll be right back. Okay, so next I'm gonna share one of my favorite little tricks, and it's so easy. There's not any skill involved in this, but it really makes such a difference with opening the eyes up, making them look bigger, brighter, and that is lining the inner rim with something light and nude colored. I like the Wander Beauty eyeliner. That's the one I have. I also like the Wet n Wild. I think it's called like the brow highlighter pencil. This one I notice is more gentle on my eyes. I have really sensitive eyes, so I kind of got away from doing this technique for a while, but my eyes have gotten better, so now I'm doing it again. This is the shade Nudist, I believe. And the trick with this is you want to find a pencil that is really soft that glides onto the inner lid easily. You don't want anything that you're going to be like having to really work to get it on, because then that's going to irritate your eye. You also want a shade, if you can see here, it's light, but it's got a slight peach tone to it, or yellow or pink. I would avoid really white liners. It just doesn't look natural. If you like it, go for it. But if you're looking for something that looks natural, stick with something that has a warmer tone to it, like a light peach or a light pink. Now I'm going to just line the inner rim here. This one is a little dry. It's actually not going on very easily. There we go. Okay, so I'm gonna do the other side. When you do this technique, I highly recommend doing a lower lash liner. You want something dark underneath there. If you just don't, it's a look. It's not that it's wrong. Again, I never want to tell you guys, don't do this, don't do that. But I feel like when you line the inner rim with something light, it's important that you do use a lower liner underneath it. Having something dark against that light really makes it pop and makes it look more natural. It gives the whole benefit we're going for, which is a more like open, wider eye. So I'm going to use the same pencil that I used on my upper lash line. I like to start in the outer corner. And for my eye shape, I like to stop in the center. Basically where my pupil, the middle of my pupil kind of. I don't take it all the way to the inner corner typically. This is going to create the illusion of a more rounder, open eye. If you bring it all the way in, it's going to create more of an almond, smaller eye, which you might go for if you have really large eyes and you like to downplay them a little bit. So next, what I like to do always is I like to go over this liner with a pencil brush. I'm going to use just a little makeup wipe to remove what I had on because I don't want it to be too dark. And I'm going to take the lightest shade. This is the first shade that I used in the crease. I'm going to take this on my pencil brush. This is going to do a couple things. It's going to set this eyeliner under the eyes. You know, there's a lot of creasing happening. Our concealer is down there, so concealer will sometimes heat up and mix with your mascara or your eyeliner, and then that's what creates like, makeup from coming down. Some people think it's their eyeliner or their mascara, but it's usually their concealer that is the culprit. But putting a powder shadow on top of that, it does a couple things. One, it kind of softens the line, makes it a little more diffused. It also intensifies it slightly, and it sets it. So if you think about setting your foundation with powder, setting it in place, it's kind of the same thing. The eyeliner is a creamy consistency. The eyeshadow is a dry powder. So it's kind of that same thing. We're gonna go right here. I got a lot of fallout right here. We're gonna clean that up. So I'm just gonna kind of run it over. Okay, now that I'm looking at the eye makeup before I apply lashes, which I will do off camera, this is real shimmery underneath here. I've had some fallout, so I want to show you how I can correct that. First, I take a brush, the brush that I use to set under my eyes, and I'll just run it over. Still there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of concealer. I'm going to clean that up. I'm also going to use the concealer to kind of lift the eye. I'm going to show you that. Let's see. Do I have a concealer here? No, I'll be right back. Okay, so I'm going to add a little concealer. Because I'm layering concealer on concealer and makeup, I want this concealer to be natural. I don't want to go in with a heavy one, and I want to use a very small amount. So I'm going to take the Charlotte Tilbury, and I'm just going to apply a real little layer underneath there. I'm not going to load it up. I did spread it because I'm going to take it up here, but I didn't like apply a lot of product. The next, what you're going to do is take a, you can take a sponge. Let's use that. This is a beauty sponge. It's the BK Beauty sponge. It has a nice pointed tip. And I'm just going to blend this in and take it up high here. Doing that is going to highlight that area and kind of lift and elongate that eye. It's also going to kind of lift your cheekbone because your cheekbone's here. Putting that lightness there is going to help give a very subtle lift to it. You can obviously go more dramatic if you are trying to create more of a lift, but this just gives the slightest bit of lift. It also cleans up everything and makes it look really nice. Perfect. Okay, next I'm going to go and apply lashes. I'm going to do that off camera because it takes me forever. The lashes that I love are the Ardell Wispies. These are great for my personal eye shape. Again, lashes are very personal. I find that these look natural, but they look a little glam too. They're not too heavy. They are shorter in the inner corner. Let me see here. Shorter in the inner corner, and then they get longer as they come out here, which is kind of the how natural lashes are supposed to look. And they're not too heavy. They're very wispy, very feathery, and they're a great price. I think I buy this 5-pack for like $12. And I probably use these, I would say I use them a few times before I have to dispose of them. All right, so we have the lashes on. After I add lashes, I do add a sheer coat of mascara on my upper lashes. I do that to, one, blend my natural lashes into the lash strips. Otherwise, depending on if your lashes are straight or if they're blonde or a different color, you'll see them. If they're straight, when people are looking at your profile, you'll see your straight lashes coming out in the lash strip. So I like to put a little mascara just to blend them in. I don't like to apply too much because I do want to use these lashes over and over. And obviously, the more more makeup you put on them, the dirtier and the harder they are to reuse. And then I do always put a little mascara on my lower lashes. So the last trick that I have to share with you guys is a little tip that I think it's kind of like that lighter liner in the inner rim. It's just that little extra thing that makes such an impact on the eyes. If you like to really like bright, wide open eyes, this is a step that you definitely want to try. And it's applying a light color right in the inner corner of your eye here, and then even pulling it down a little bit. When I worked at MAC, I've told this story before, there was a senior artist are the artists that would go and work backstage. They would do, New York Fashion Week, Paris Fashion Week, all of that. She called this instant celebrity, and I never forgot it. It's basically that little technique that just elevates your makeup to that extra level of glam. Now, you can do this with a shimmer, or you can do it with a matte. If you do it with a matte, it's going to look more natural. It's not going to look intentional. People won't be able to put their finger on it. They'll just look at you and think, oh, her eyes look so bright and open. But if you do shimmer, it's going to look more glamorous. So let's try both. Let's try both. I'm going to use the light shade here. This is the one I did under my brow bone. And we'll do it on this side so you can see what that does. And basically all you're doing is just, putting it right there in that inner corner and bringing it down a little bit. You want to be careful not to bring it down here underneath the eye. You just want to keep it right there in that tear duct. So you can see that that's very soft, very natural. If you do it with shimmer, I'm going to use the same shimmer that I used on the lid. This one is nice, but it's a little too yellow. I don't want it to be too yellow. So I'm going to go in here very lightly, and I'm just going to apply that right in the inner corner. And then you don't want to do too much. You just want it to be very soft, very subtle. So do you see the difference in the two? I kind of like the matte one better, to be honest. So I'm going to go back and take the matte and go over this, which will just tone down the shimmer a bit. It'll still be a little shimmery, but it'll tone it down. And then I'm going to add a little shimmer over here just so we're even. Perfect. Okay. So that wraps up the eye makeup tips and tricks. I feel like this video is going to be really long, but I wanted to just share all of my tips and techniques and tricks. If you've been following me for a while, you've seen these in past videos, but these truly are the foundations of creating a more defined eye and understanding how to enhance or kind of tweak or alter the shape of the eye if that's what you're looking to do. I hope you guys found this video helpful. I would love to hear what you guys learned from this video. If you picked up anything new, let me know in the comment section below. As always, share your tips and tricks, your favorite tips and tricks in the comment section below. I love learning from you guys, and I love you guys sharing tips and tricks and learning from each other. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm on to film the lip portion of this series and wrap this up. I hope you guys are enjoying it. I hope you have a fantastic day, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.